Hey guys, Charles Jaeger for Tuts Plus. Today we're going to be looking at a quick tip on how to create snow for a snow globe. And this is a collaboration tutorial with Vector Tuts. They've actually created this dragon and snow globe in Illustrator, and they contacted us over here at AE Tuts and were wanting us to create some snow for this. So if you're interested in that tutorial, definitely check it out. There'll be a link in the description. And the cool thing about this effect, we're going to make this without any third-party plugins. We're going to be using CC Particle Systems 2. So let's get to it. Okay guys, first thing we're gonna do is create a new composition. Call it snow. Make it 720p. Hit okay. All right, I'm gonna right click and create a new solid. Call it snow particles. Okay, now I'm gonna apply the effect CC Particle Systems 2. Drag that onto my solid. Okay, if we scroll through the timeline here, we can see that this is creating some particles, and this is really similar to CC Particle World. But essentially the difference is that CC Particle Systems 2 is it's just a 2D effect. So it actually kind of renders somewhat faster than CC Particle World, which is actually a 3D effect. You can see if I create a new camera here, and if I hit C to navigate around, it's not doing anything. Whereas if this was CC Particle World, we could navigate around this particle system in real 3D. But since it's Particle Systems 2, we can't do that. I'm going to delete that camera. Okay, let's toggle down some of the settings here just so we can get a better idea of what we're working with. And obviously right now we're not getting the effect we want. So the first thing I would suggest you do is change the particle to a quad polygon. I'm going to set the birth size and death size to 0.05. And this is essentially going to imitate little flakes of snow in the snow globe. If you look at a snow globe, usually the little flakes in there are square shaped, kind of like glitter. If you want this to be something different, like a shaded sphere, you can go ahead and change it to that. It's whatever your preference is. I'm going to change the max opacity to 100%, the birth color and death color both to white. I'm going to change the size variation to be 0. And just for the sake of this tutorial, I'm actually going to bump this up to 0.1, just so you guys can see this a little bit easier for the time being. Now if we scroll through, we can still see that the particles now are essentially just emitting and falling down. It's not very snow globe-like, so what we can do now, let's go up to the physics, and I'm going to change this animation type to vortex. So now we're kind of getting a tornado-like animation with these particles, so we need to increase the producer radius. I'm going to increase this to 40 on the X and the Y axis. So now we're starting to get something that looks a little bit more like particles possibly floating around a snow globe. Still have a little work to do, but it's coming along. Let's go up here and let's change the birth rate to be 2.4. Let's change the longevity to be 3. Let's go back down to physics for a second and let's check out the velocity here, which is essentially going to be how quick these things shoot out from the emitter. I'm going to set this actually on 0.2. And I'm going to set the gravity to also be 0.2. So now if we look at this, this is actually looking a lot more like snow in a snow globe. It's been shaken up. We need to create a mass to essentially contain these particles. And one of the problems with using this effect, CC Particle Systems 2, I'm going to toggle this up. If we try to create a mask on top of this layer, we get some undesirable results with this edging here. So I'm going to hit Control-Z to undo that mask. What we can do instead, let's create another solid. I'm going to right-click, create a new solid. Call this matte. I'm going to hit OK. I'm going to grab the mask tool again. I'm going to click in the center. I'm going to hold on Control Shift, I believe Command Shift on a Mac, and create a sphere here. And after I've got that created, I'm going to turn off the mask visibility setting. And I'm going to go down to our snow particles, and I'm going to turn the track matte to alpha matte. So now we can see these particles are just inside of this sphere, which now it's looking a lot more like a snow globe. We can sell this a little bit more. If we click on the matte, I'm going to hit MM to bring up the mask properties, and the mask expansion, I'm going to actually bring it to the negative to bring it in a little bit, and then I'm going to bring up the mask feather. And what this is going to do is essentially kind of imitate the visibility we have when the particles kind of get around the edge of the glass, like on a real snow globe. When the particles get near the edge, you know, they get distorted because of refraction and everything else. This kind of gives us a little bit more realistic looking result. Let's do a quick ramp preview on this. So that's looking pretty good. Obviously, at the very beginning here, we see the particles being born, and we don't really want to see that initially in our animation. So what I would suggest doing is grabbing the snow particles layer and around the 1 or 2 second mark and just pulling it down to the beginning of your composition and just grab the back end and extend it to the length of your comp. So one of the first things I noticed in the ramp preview was that the particles seem to be moving through the water a little too quickly. In reality, the water would kind of be a little bit more resistant on these flakes as they fly through. So what we can do is click on the snow particles layer, and back on under effects controls, we can increase the resistance here. And if we watch, you can actually see what this kind of does to the particles in real time. I'm going to set this on about 15. And now let's do another ramp preview. And now you can see the particles are moving a little bit slower, a little bit more organic. But we want to sell this to make it look like water even more. So what we're going to do is stack a couple effects on top of the CC particle systems effect. And the first effect we're going to apply is turbulent displace. Select it, drag it on top of the snow particles. And we want to create that kind of warble look that the water has when the particles are going through it. I'm going to set this on 35 for the amount and the size to be about 10. Some of the particles now are kind of waving in the water. It's a very subtle effect, but it's going to help sell that this is water. Another effect we can apply is the bulge effect. And this is going to kind of give us that glass distortion that we would have with the snow globe. So I'm going to move this to be in the center of our snow particles layer. And I'm going to increase the radius here to be about the size of the sphere on both the horizontal and vertical axis. And the bulge height, I'm going to bring this down to about 0.2. It's going to be another really subtle effect. You may not notice it immediately, but it's going to add just a little bit more realism to the snow globe. One last thing we can do is actually animate these snowflakes falling down after it was shaken up. So it's been sitting for a second. We want the flakes to fall back down on the floor. I'm going to close up these two effects and open back up CC Particle Systems 2. And what we need to do is a little bit of keyframing. We need to keyframe. I'm going to have it start falling around 3 seconds or so. Keyframe the animation and also keyframe the birth rate. So I'm going to hit U on the keyboard to bring up my keyframes. And I'm going to move down. I'm going to move down just a little bit, and I'm going to change the animation to be direction. And if I scroll now, we should see some of the particles looking as if they're kind of falling toward the floor now, and that's exactly what we want. But obviously, the birth rate's staying the same, so the particles don't really look like they're settling. So I'm going to go down a little bit further and set the birth rate to 0. So now if we ramp preview this, we have the snow particles floating around, and now they gradually fall back down on the bottom. All right, so now let's composite this in our Dragon Snow Globe Illustrator file. If you don't have these files, you can easily get them by downloading this project file. They'll be in the project. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is create a new composition. I'm gonna call this Snow Globe. Hit okay. Now I'm gonna drag my Illustrator files into this composition. We've got the under, which is the bottom of the snow globe, and the background. Got the actual dragon itself and the glass. And obviously this doesn't fill up our entire composition, but I can scale this up. I'm gonna hold shift and select all of these. I'm gonna grab the edge here while holding shift and scale this up. And obviously if we zoom in here, we can kind of see this is a little bit fuzzy, almost looking as if it's a little bit distorted. If I hit F4 here to toggle the switches, we can turn on the collapse transformation settings for each one of these layers. And since these are Illustrator files and they're vectors, this is going to bring out the real resolution of these images. This will slow down your render times and your preview times. So probably just for the sake of previewing, I'm going to turn this back off just so you guys can see this a little bit quicker. Now what I'm going to do is bring back in the snow composition. And I may have to scale this a little bit. The top of the glass there to where it looks right. Now that we've got that there, we can actually bring the snow below the glass layer, the top of the snow globe. And you can see the reflection off the glass of this Illustrator art. It's kind of on top of the snow now, kind of making the composite look a little more realistic. I'm going to move this a little bit more too. And there we go. Now we have our snow animating in our snow globe. If we want to, we can also change the transfer mode, hit F4 again, of the snow to something like add if we want that to pop a little bit more. Change that back to normal. And actually, if we jump back inside of the snow composition, we can change the particle type to be a shaded sphere or whatever we want it to be. And if we jump back in the snow globe comp, we can see that it's already reflected here. So that's looking really cool. So that's really easy to customize. I'm actually going to change this back to quad polygon. And I'm going to show you guys one more quick effect you can do to easily change the color of these particles if you want to have them be multicolored. Obviously, we could change it here in the birth and death, but that's only going to give us one color. And so what we can do is add the effect Colorama to our snow particles. And right off the bat, it's not going to look very good, so we're going to want to toggle the Modify tab and turn off Modify Alpha. And now we can see this looks a lot cleaner on top of these particles. And all you have to do now is essentially change the output cycle. And since Colorama essentially looks at the luminance of these particles, the ones that are brighter will be one color and the darker ones will be another one based on the scale. So essentially it goes from bright to dark and wraps back around. So we can set this one of the presets, like Deep Ocean. It's going to give us a variety of different blues and purples here. If we jump back in our snow globe, we can see that composited here. And there we go. That's a quick, easy way to create snow particles for like a snow globe or something else of the like in After Effects with no third-party plugins. Hopefully you guys found this useful, and definitely explore the CC Particle Systems 2 effect. It's pretty powerful, but the great thing about it is it renders extremely quick. All right, guys. Charles Jaeger for Tuts Plus.